I'm Santosh Kadankar. Today I'm teaching you dynamics of machine. In the dynamics of machine, I'm focusing on to the gyroscope. In gyroscope, we are studying stability of a four-wheeler drive moving in a curved path. Okay, this is a four-wheeler. This is a front. This is a rear. The rear is nothing but separated by a distance x, and the front wheel is separated by distance l. This is R, curving path, where WP will come in picture. WP is nothing but V by R, angular velocity, we call as angular velocity. Now, if I see from this part, this diagram, this is the center of gravity, which is because it is turning to the left direction, the center of gravity will be moved away from here at a distance of h from the surface to the gravity, center of gravity. Now, as the four-wheeler automobile taking it right towards the left side, as shown in the figure, the wheel A and C, the wheel A and C act as inner wheels, and B and D out act as outer wheels. The center of gravity GC of the vehicle lies in the vertical above the roadside. This is above the roadside. The stability, it is essential that no wheel is lifted off the ground while the vehicle taking the turn. This is the condition to fulfill as long as the vertical reaction of the ground on the wave on any of the wheel is positive. Okay, now it is taking this direction, the gyroscopic effect will be here, the reactive gyroscopic will be in opposite direction, where now IW is nothing but the mass moment of inertia of the wheel, EW is the mass moment of inertia of the rotating part, E is nothing but refers to the engine, and this is refers to the wheel here. Omega E is nothing but angular velocity of the engine. Omega W is nothing but angular velocity of the wheel. I is the gear ratio. It is focused only for the engine part. V is the linear speed of the vehicle. It is nothing but omega W divided by RW. R is the radius of curvature in meters. Mass M is the mass of the vehicle. H is the distance from the gravity for above the ground road surface. From the road surface to the GC. X is the width of the track, and L is the length of the wheel base. Next, where WP is nothing the angular velocity of the precision, V by R, where P is nothing but the force due to gyroscopic effect of the wheel. We are taking the wheel P here. The force due to gyroscopic effect of the engine, we are taking the Q, and centrifugal force we are referring as the F here. Now, first I will go for reaction due to weight of the vehicle. Now, as the load on each wheel W by 4, I am taking W by 4 because there are 4 wheels, it's nothing but mg divided by 4, which is acting downward, then the road reaction will be what? Upward. Road reaction over each wheel W by 4, mg by 4, upward. Total reaction will be upward. Now, second is nothing but the reaction due to gyroscopic effect of the wheel. Now there are, first we have considered the weight, next the reaction due to the gyroscopic effect of the wheel. As the wheel is nothing but, we know that the formula for gyroscopic effect, g omega is equal to 4 I w omega w plus wp. Why I have taken 4? There are 4 wheels, If there are two wheels, we have to took three. There are two wheels. If three, three wheels. This is the couple. Where W omega, omega W is nothing but V by RW, and WP is nothing but omega P is nothing but V by R. Now we are assuming that as per the direction, as it is moving in the forward path, the wheel is rotating in this direction. Now I will hold the pen here. The thumb indicate the direction of the wheel. This is the direction. Now, as it takes the left turn is nothing but it moves in this direction. Therefore, I will write left turn here. This will be active gyroscope. This will be reactive gyroscope. The hold the pen in this way. The finger indicate curving. This will be active gyroscope. This is a reactive gyrocouple. Okay, we are taking the left turn here. Left turn based upon the direction of the wheel. Because it is moves in a forward path, therefore wheel rotate in this direction. I will hold the pen in that direction. This thumb indicate arrow of this one. I have written here. I have taken left turn. This is active, this is a reactive. Now we have to find out the couple due to these forces. Now how to find this one? Because I am viewing from the rear end. It appears in this way. Now this part will be act here, and this part will be act here. Now this is nothing but what? Based on diagram, this is nothing but what? If you combine this one, it act as a comma c, and this one act as a b comma c, and the reaction due to gyroscopic effect on the wheel, we have considered p here. P and p at a distance of x. Therefore, the couple will exist here. I will write based on this one. The couple due to this force. Is equal to Px. The couple will exist. This arrow is brought here, and this arrow is brought here. And this is nothing but we call as the inner wheel, and this is nothing but outer wheel. Based on the diagram, this is referred as the inner, and this one is referred as the outer here. Now P is the couple. This is a couple. Therefore, it can be written as Px is nothing but 4GW omega W WP. Px is nothing but couple. The couple is nothing but gyroscopic couple. This formula can be written here. Now, P is nothing but what? 4IW omega W omega P divided by X. Omega X. Now we got the couple here. Now load on each wheel. Load on each wheel B and C will be P by 2. I am taking the P by 2 because I am considering only two wheels here. Therefore, I have to consider P by 2 is equal to 4. P is nothing but 4IW omega W WP divided by 2X. Now, this one is nothing but outer, which is acting downward here. Now, load on each wheel A and C. This will be A and C, and this will be A and D. This one will be A and D. and D. A and D. Now it can be written as what? P divided by 2. What is P? 4i w omega w wp divided by 2x. Now here it acts as a upward. Write upward here. Upward. Now road reaction plays an important role. Road reaction. This is for inner wheel. For inner wheel is nothing but P by 2. Reaction for the inner wheel. This is the inner wheel. Right, in inner here. Inner wheel. This is the outer wheel. For inner wheel, P by 2, or you can write A and C. Inner wheel, P by 2. If it is upward, the reaction will be downward. Downward. Now, B and C, B and D, outer wheel, P by 2. If it is downward, the outer road reaction will be upward. This completes the reaction due to gyroscopic effect of the wheel. Now we have to consider the reaction due to gyroscopic effect of the engine. We have to consider. Now I am going for the engine here. Now reaction due to gyroscopic effect on the engine. That is third part, the reaction due to gyroscopic effect on engine. Now gyroscopic for engine is nothing but EI is equal to EI, GI is equal to EI, WE, WP. There is only one engine in the car, therefore if there are two engine, two, four engine, four, only one engine, one, where WE is nothing but I, W, so WW is equal to IE here, and WP is nothing but V by R. I made a mistake here. WE is nothing but I into WE. Now I is equal to, okay, should be W, sorry, W. I is equal to gear is what, W is equal to W. Okay, next. Okay. Now, the reaction due to gyroscopic coupling. Now, the engine in the car, in this car, the engine, this is the engine, assume it this is the engine, which is rotating in this direction. In a clockwise direction, because it's just rotating clockwise direction, in the same direction. Then I will hold the pen in the clockwise direction. I will hold pen and this direction, the clock, I will hold here. Now thumb indicate in this direction. I will draw a line here. And taking left turn, draw here. This is active gyroscope. This will be reactive gyroscope. Hold this one. This will be active. This will be reactive. Now, We are viewing from the rear end here. Now, rear end. Okay. Now, while finding the reaction due to gyroscopic couple, we have to see from this one, this end. This end. This act as a front and this act as a back or rear. This act as a front and this act as a rear while drawing for the reaction to gyroscopic couple. That means it appears in this way. Now it appears in this way. Active. Active will be here. And the reactive will be here. This will be Q. This is also Q. At a distance of L. A distance of L. This moves here and this will be here. As it is followed in the first diagram. In this diagram, we have followed the same concept. And this part moves here and this part moves here. Now, this is nothing but what? Front. This is nothing but rear. Or back wheel. The rear or back wheel. Now, same diagram, if it is tilted in this way, it appears in this way. This will be Q. This will be Q. At a distance of L. This act as a front. And this act as a rear. Now, what is front? Front is nothing but AB. A comma B. And rear is nothing but CD. If you see from this direction, if you see from this direction, it will be CD, C comma D, C comma D. Now we have to find out the load on each front wheel. Load on the each front wheel. Load on each front wheel is equal to Q divided by 2. I omega W, I'm just replacing this one with the help of this one, WP divided by 2L. Now here, it is a front, it acts upward, upward. The load on each rear wheel. Rear wheel. I have taken 2 here because I am taking 2 here because Q divided by 2 because there is 2 wheels 2 I omega W P divided by 2L. Divided by 2. Now here act downward, right downward here. Now road reaction plays an important role. Road reaction. Front wheel. That is A comma B. Reaction will be Q by 2, front wheel, A comma B, upward, it should be downward now. Rear wheel, that is C comma D, Q by 2, upward, it is downward, you have to write upward. Next, we got the reaction of the self load, reaction due to the wheel, reaction due to gyroscopic effect. Now, reaction due to centrifugal force. Last one. The reaction due to centrifugal force. Reaction due to centrifugal effect. What is centrifugal force? Centrifugal force. Fc is equal to mv square by r. Fc is equal to m omega square r. What is omega? M is equal to w by r. whole square into r. This and this are cancels and becomes, sorry, v square by m v square divided by r. Okay, I have directly written it. Now, when the couple comes in picture, centrifugal, the couple due to centrifugal force, couple due to the centrifugal force or force is nothing but Fc is equal to m v square divided by r. Now, you have to refer the first diagram. There is a couple here. Therefore, you have to consider H into H. Now, as we have to find out the couple due to force, how to find that one? Now, as the car is moving here, as it moves to the left turn, the centrifugal force act in outer direction. Therefore, we can write in this way. If you see from the rear end, A comma C, and if you see from the rear end, A comma C, B comma D, the centrifugal force will act here, and next will be act here from the bottom, at a distance of X. F, I am considering centrifugal force F. Now, coupled due to this force will be is equal to Fx. This is the couple right here. Fx is equal to M V square R into H, where F is equal to M V square R into H by X. Now load on each wheel, you have to write load on each wheel, each outer wheel, this will be outer, this will be inner wheel, we have seen from the rear end, outer wheel B and D will be F by 2 is equal to M V square R into H by 2X. Now outer wheel, it act downward, right downward. The load on each inner wheel, that is A comma C, F divided by 2, because I am taking two, only the two wheels I am considering, M V square R into H by 2X, acting upward, right upward. Now we have to write the road reaction. The road reaction for this one will be, the outer will be down upward and the inner will be downward. The road reaction B and D, outer wheel F by 2 upward, A comma C inner wheel F by 2 downward. If it is upward, you have to write downward. Now you have to find out the total vertical reaction of the wheels. We have to find out the total vertical reaction of the wheel. Now, total vertical reaction of the wheel at wheels. First, I will consider A. For A, what is the reaction? The reaction is upward. Now, upward I am considering a positive and downward I will consider negative. Now, it is upward, only reaction you have to consider, that is W by 4. For B, for C and D, everything will be same. it is upward. Now reaction due to the gyroscopic couple reaction you have to see. For A, it is downward minus P by 2, minus P by 2. For C, it is minus downward minus P by 2. For B, it is upward, for B plus P by 2. For D, it is upward plus P by 2. Next, we'll go for engine. For engine, front reaction will be downward minus Q by 2. For B, minus Q by 2. For C, plus Q by 2. For D, plus Q by 2. It is upward. Next, centrifugal force. Centrifugal force, the reaction will be for B, for A, it is downward minus F by 2. For C, downward minus F by 2. For B, plus F by 2. F by 2. For D, plus F by 2. This is the reaction for this one. Now, based on this one, you have to draw over the first sheet. In this sheet, you have to draw everything here. Now, first reaction for A, that means, now this is A, this is A, W by 4, which is acting upward, W by 4, which is acting upward, W by 4, which is acting upward, W by 4, which is acting upward. For B, everything is positive, acting upward here. Now for A, I'm just focusing your A downward, A downward P by 2 minus Q by 2 downward F downward. For B, upward P by 2 Q downward F by 2 upward. Next, for C, now see here, this is the reaction for C. P by 2 will be downward, P by 2 downward, Q by 2 upward, F by 2 downward. For D, P by 2 upward, Q by 2 upward, F by 2 upward. In this way, you have to represent finally over the diagram. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.